open thou my lips,
and my mouth shall show forth thy praise.
Make peace, O God, to deliver me.
As it was.
as our custom is toward those who love your name.
Your testimonies are wonderful. Therefore, my soul keeps them.
The entrance of your words gives light. It gives understanding to the simple.
I open my mouth and attend, for I long for your commandments.
Look upon me and be merciful to me, as your custom is toward those who love your name.
I direct my steps by your word. And let my dignity have dominion over me.
Redeem me from the oppression of man, that I may keep your precepts.
Make your face shine upon your servant, and teach me your statutes.
Rivers of water run down from my eyes, because men do not keep your law.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Look upon me and be merciful to me, as your custom is toward those who love your name.
Reading from Hebrews, the 12th chapter. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him who endured such hostility from sinners against himself, lest you become weary and discouraged in your souls. You have not yet resisted to bloodshed, striving against sin. And you have forgotten the exhortation which speaks to you as to sons. My son, do not despise the chastening of the Lord, nor be discouraged when you are rebuked by him. For whom the Lord loves, he chastens, and scourges every son whom he receives. If you endure chastening, God deals with you as with sons. For what son is there whom a father does not chasten? But if you are without chastening, of which all have become partakers, then you are illegitimate and not sons. Furthermore, we have had human fathers who corrected us, and we paid the respect. Shall we not much more readily be in submission to the Father of spirits and live? For they indeed for a few days chastened us as seemed best to them, but he for our profit, that we may be partakers of his holiness. Now, no chastening seems to be joyful for the present, but painful. Nevertheless, afterward it yields the peaceable fruit of righteousness to those who have been trained by it. Therefore, strengthen the hands which hang down, and the feeble knees, and make straight paths for your feet, so that what is lame may not be dislocated, but rather be healed. Pursue peace with all people, and holiness, without which no one will see the Lord, looking carefully lest anyone fall short of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up cause trouble, and by this many become defiled, lest there be any fornicator or profane person like Esau, who for one morsel of food sold his birthright. For you know that afterward, when he wanted to inherit the blessing, he was rejected, for he found no place for repentance, though he sought it diligently with tears.
But the Lord have mercy upon us.
Responsory.
is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path.
Lord, I have loved the meditation of your house, and love this where your glory dwells.
Blessed are those who hear the word of God and keep it.
Lord, I have loved that invitation of your house, and the place where your glory dwells.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Lord, I have loved that invitation of your house, and the place where your glory dwells.
Well, let's enjoy together this evening.
Spirit, so you will restore. shall praise you as I do this day. The Father shall make known your truth to the children. The Lord was ready to save me. Therefore, we will sing my songs with stringed instruments all the days of our life in the house of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. He who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lord, we beseech thee, grant thy people grace to withstand the temptations of the devil, and with pure hearts and minds to follow thee, the only God, through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end. Father, almighty and everlasting God, who has safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, that all our doings being ordered by thy governance, may be righteous in thy sight. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end. Bless we the Lord. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Ghost be with you all.